Hey everybody, so I am G1 Writer with G1 Insights. Today I'm simply going to talk to you all about how to balance love and relationships with career and money. How do you balance it all, right? A lot of relationships tend to fail because either money is a problem, or there's no communication, or people are just simply afraid to express themselves in relationships. And I think that is really, really important to keep balance. And let's face it, a lot of us either don't have enough patience or we don't have enough balance. And you want to know exactly how to do that, okay? So I don't really have no spectacular big list or anything to really read out to you guys. This is just strictly coming from me, and it's raw. Okay, so you get it when you get it at, okay? So the thing is, for one, you have to simply know what you want, first of all, okay? A lot of people get into relationships and don't really know what they want. They say that they do, and then a year, 2, 3 years later, now they have this master plan. They want to go back to school. They want to do this. They want to go jogging, or they want to travel the world, right? The key to any relationship, even with yourself, is just simply identifying with self. What do you want? Seriously, what do you want? Once you got that idea planted in your mind, right, and you know what you want, now is the manifestation part, right? You have to now put it in the universe and let it go. You work towards it. You work hard at it, no matter what it is. If your goal is to, if you want a husband that is a certain way, again, you know, many of my other videos, I always talk about writing things down and how that is a great way of manifestation. However, I also talk about taking action, okay? So if that is something that you want to make sure that you are doing something every single day that is going to allow you to be the reflection of what you desire, okay? So that is something that I actually learned myself with dating people, right? When I was really serious about settling down and I did not want to, you know, keep living this way or that way, one of the things that I decided to do was understand what I want. What do I want? How do I get it? Oh, I know how I get it is I am now going to become a reflection of the type of man that I desire. So it's the same thing. If you want to be an author, you have now need to become a reflection of an author. If your goal is to travel the world, your goal is now to be a reflection of what that even feels like. That means waking up every day with a goal, a plan, right? Every single day you have something lined up. You know what you want. You're working towards it. You're working. You're saving your money. You're investing your money. You're doing everything possible to make sure that you are going to be able to travel the world, right? You're going to look at all the different maps. You're probably going to study geography. I don't know. But a lot of people that do travel, trust me, they have plans. They have strategy to their method. Like, they're not going to just go out there and just hop in something, right? So they want to know about the city, the town, the language, right? They want to know these things because they love to travel. So they want to know what they are getting themselves into. And it's the same way with the relationship, okay? In a relationship, it's the same exact way. You have to now prepare yourself to be a reflection of the type of spouse that you desire, okay? So you can't necessarily be the type of person that is very quarrelsome, right? Someone who likes to start up a lot of drama, a lot of headache, a lot of trouble, who could be very grumpy and mean all the time, and then want somebody who is very elegant and sophisticated and who drives a Ferrari and who's strictly a businessman or a businesswoman, right? We have to change our mindset. So that is what I mean when I say become a reflection of the type of spouse that you desire, okay? This is all about balance, guys, okay? That is what I'm teaching you, is how to properly have that balance between love and money. Because, again, a lot of people think that you can't do both. But you can if you just simply learn how to keep the balance, okay? And part of keeping that balance is strictly, okay, knowing what you want, manifesting that, working towards it, right? So if you might say, okay, well, right now my goal is to educate myself. I want to get my money together before I get married, before I settle down, before I move in with him, or before I move in with her. This is the things that I want to do. Do that first. I think that is brilliant to work on your finances and to work on yourself and to even work on self-development. I think that is also very important before you get into a relationship with anybody, right? But if you're really, really thinking or considering about settling down, you may want to really, really think about what is it that you want? What do you desire? Work towards it. And once you get it, right, you don't stop. You don't put yourself on hold, right? Because now that you are sure and you are absolutely certain about what you desire, right? And a person in your life, when you meet this new individual, now you can present your goals. You can present what you desire. You can present what you love. And they can now do the same. And if you guys can both agree or agree not to agree, I guess, but you know, if you guys can come to some type of conclusion on how you guys would travel the world, or you know, maybe you can go to school while they work, or maybe you can work while they go to school. It's all about compromise, okay? So it's definitely worth it. Trust me, it is definitely worth it. Trust me. You can still work on your goals and be yourself and still be happily in love, okay? So the thing is, again, it's balance. You know what you want, you're going after what you want, now that you achieved it, right? Or for some of you, let's say you meet someone in the process of going after that first goal, right? You meet someone in the process after going after that goal, what do? Again, you don't stop. You share with them what your goal is. Listen, I think you're great, but I'm focused. I'm focused on my career. Right? I'm focused on school. I want my degree. Or I'm focused on my health. Whatever that goal is, let that person know ahead of time. And then they can now decide to say, okay, do I want to stick on this journey with this person? Or is this going to be too much for me? Right? Or, yeah, I think that's good. I like that. I love the fact that you have goals. Let's do this together. As a matter of fact, I'll work out with you on every Saturday. Like, so the thing is, when you tell someone up front what your goals are and what your desires are, right, now they know. They have an opportunity to say either they want to deal with you or they're not, okay? So now that you're clear about your desires, now you're manifesting, you're going after your goals, you're taking action, you meet somebody in the midst of you taking action, you tell them your goals, and give them a choice to whether to stick with you or to get out. Because again, you don't lose yourself in the process. We're not doing that. You're not losing yourself in the process, okay? So that is the whole thing. We don't want you to lose yourself. And I believe that that is part of a lot of things of why a lot of people are afraid to get into relationships, simply because they feel like they're gonna lose themselves. Or a lot of people feel like, well, I don't really have myself together. But the beautiful part is, what I found really beautiful is that when you have the right spouse, even if you are not necessarily where you want to be at the moment, when you have the right spouse, right, it doesn't matter. It's going to naturally flow anyway, because see, they're going to add to your life. They're not going to subtract. They're not going to distract you. They're going to amplify you. They're going to elevate you and make you feel secure, safe, and loving. Okay, they are going to create a stable foundation for you, and I mean emotionally, so that way you're not being distracted. They will be encouraging, okay? They will be the one to uplift you when you feel like that exam is really stressing you out, right? Or when you feel like you can't really seem to study, they'll be the one that'll probably study with you. Or when you're having issues at work, they'll probably be the one to give you a nice back massage or a nice foot rub, right? Like, they'll be totally supportive. So you don't necessarily have to worry about losing yourself in a relationship. And I think that is another key to touch on, is that a lot of people are afraid of losing themselves. I've been there. I know what that feels like, to totally lose yourself in someone, and everything is about them and what they need and what they want and what they feel and what they desire. And then little do you know, when they're not around, now you don't know what to do. Now you're stuck. Now you don't know how to feel about anything really, because everything in your life just revolved around that particular individual. And I think that a lot of people go through that, and then when they break up and it's time for someone new to enter their life, they don't give that other person a chance because of those reasons. And which brings me to another point, really. So again, between having balance, between love and happiness and career, you can absolutely do both. Okay, but the next thing is getting over that fear of rejection, getting over that fear of, you know, I can't do this, I can't do both. You can absolutely do both, okay? If we change our mindset and we are manifesting and we're going after what we want, even if it is money, if you are going after money, you like, look, I need money, I don't got time for this love stuff right now, right? The person who loves you, who is really, really for you, would not try to stop you from getting money. In fact, they will probably help you come up with more ways on how to get money. So you will know, like, the right spouse for you simply based on one of those characteristics. Like, they're not the type that's going to be trying to distract you. What you doing, yo? You've been at work all day. Like, no, they're not going to treat you like that. Or you're not going to have her, you know, calling you saying, where you been? Why you not home yet? Why you ain't calling me? Like, she's not going to do that. She wants you to get money. She wants to inspire you, right? So she wants you to be your best self. So you don't have to have that fear of being rejected. If you plan out your wants and you deal with that first, and I don't mean forever. Some of you take forever to plan this out. It does not take that long. And I'm going to go back to one of the first things that I love, which is writing things out. Close that book. Put it away. Roll the paper up if you need to, but put it away and don't worry about it. Don't look at it. You know, a lot of people talk about vision boards and things like that, and, you know, and they like to write things on it. You don't got to do all that. It works better and faster when you're closing it and you're leaving it and you're not thinking about it. What a vision board does is you have to see it every day. So you're constantly thinking, oh, I got to get that. I got to get that. Oh, I got to get married. Oh, I have to get that house. Oh, I have to get that car. Oh, I have to finish school. If you have something that you're constantly looking at, your mind is racing, okay? You're constantly worried. And that's constantly reminding you of the things that you want because you're like, okay, I've been at this job for like 8 months now. I still don't have my car. And you're looking at this board and you're trying to figure it out, okay, so I've been saving all this money and yet I still don't have my degree. I still don't have the trade that I want. I still don't have that Lexus that I desired. So I don't like those vision boards, okay? It's cool for some people if you like art, I guess, but to me, that's all there is an art project. And when it comes to love, especially, I see a lot of people that put like hearts and big diamond rings, like they'll print out the picture out of a magazine or something and they'll put it on there. That's great. All that stuff is great, honey. But would I tell you, listen, you're doing it wrong, okay? When you're manifesting something, you want to close it? Listen, I even did it with my own marriage. I did the same thing. I had my paper, I rolled it away, and I never opened it again until I met someone new. And when I met him, I went down my list. I went through everything. A lot of you noticed already. I tell you this before, right? So that's what I did. I didn't worry about it. I put it away. I put it in God's hands, and I let it be. Because that is how you naturally manifest, my love. And it's the same way when you're trying to decide, okay, can I have love? Can I have money? You can have both. But you got to put that plan into action. You got to write it out, put that plan into action, let that person know where your mind is at and where your heart is at, so that way they can decide if they want to roll with you or not. And then you have to also let them know, listen, it's okay to be vulnerable, okay? Let me put that out there, because I noticed that's another issue that we're going to talk about soon. Maybe not in this video if I don't have time, but we will talk about it, okay? I think that's another issue, is that a lot of us are afraid to be vulnerable when we meet people. And I'm not saying to be weak, all right? Because a lot of people look at vulnerability as being weak, right? And a lot of people think sensitivity is being weak, right? But what they don't understand is that when you show your vulnerability and you show that sensitive side, right, people will gravitate to you a lot more. So it allows you to be more open. Listen, I've been through a lot. So right now, I'm just strictly focused on my career, getting my money together. I have children to look after. I don't have time for this love stuff right now. But let me tell you, the right person will wait. The right person will be there to support you no matter what. And you will know when somebody is for you, because you won't have to do too much chasing and, you know, chasing them down and begging and pleading. You won't have to do that, my love. When God has put a man in your life, especially, and I feel like I'm talking to a lot of my ladies out there, when a man is for you, honey, trust me, he will chase you down. He will, you know, and I know some people will say, well, this guy didn't chase me down. Then we got together. He cheated on me in the first 6 months, right? So, I know that too, but that's not the type of chasing down I'm talking about. I'm talking about the type of chase me down where you know, I didn't told you to wait 4 years ago, 2 years ago, or 6 years ago, and you still waiting. You dated other people, I dated other people, you got your heart broken, I got my heart broken, but you still, in the back of your mind, you still love me, right? So no matter what happens, destiny will always bring you guys back together. So it really doesn't matter necessarily what, you know, or who came along or what they did. It's gonna work out regardless. Not now. So hold on, I take this real serious. That's my dad, okay, but you can't get in my video. So it doesn't matter, okay? You have to have balance. And a lot of people, you'd be surprised how a lot of people don't have balance when it comes to if they need career or they want love. You can absolutely have both, okay? It doesn't matter. You don't have to feel like you have to focus on one thing and you have to push everybody aside. You don't have to do that. It's all about compromise. And like I said, when that person is for you, they're going to support you. They're going to be there. They're going to make you laugh. They're going to help you study. So don't feel afraid like you're going to lose yourself. Don't feel like you have to, you know, walk away. Don't feel like you can't give your all to this person. You can. Right? Because like I said, the right person for you will wait. The right person will understand they're focused right now. They're grinding right now. They're working right now. They will get it. But they will also remind you of you. Like, they will always be there to remind you of how fantastic you are and to let your hair down and to have fun and to just enjoy life, right? Like, you will constantly be reminded of that with this person. So it doesn't matter. And it's not saying that this is going to be one of those relationships where it's going to be perfect and there's not going to be any obstacles. I never said that, right? Just because this person is good for you doesn't mean that there are no obstacles, okay? And that's another point. A lot of people think that relationships are supposed to be like drama-free, no headaches. That is BS, okay? I don't know who put that lie out there, but that is not the truth. When you are really in love with a person, you will absolutely have disagreements. There will be frustrations. There will be times where you don't even want to be next to that person. You got to remember, guys, we are human still. So even though we have a spiritual side to us, we are so human. And we have emotions and we have feelings and all these different things that come up and stir us up all in the wrong way. And sometimes we say things we don't mean, but real love and destiny will never totally separate you guys. You will always come back together. You will always speak and you will always continue to love each other. Even if you separated, even if you broke up, even if you divorced, right? The love will always be there. It will never die, truly. Okay, because like I said, when someone is strictly for you, nothing else matters. You can work, you can date 20 other people, you can have sex with a whole bunch of other people. It doesn't matter. Destiny. Because see, it's our will, right? And then there's God's will, right? So we can sit here and say, yeah, well, I don't want to be with that person, right? And then God is like, oh, it doesn't matter. You're going to be with that person anyway. Right? Or trust me, I know. Like somebody, you can be totally in it, like, no, I don't want to be with this person. I'm good. I'm done. Right? And then you're constantly reminded of reasons why you need to stay. So you absolutely can have balance. You absolutely can have love and money and have a fantastic career and still be happy. And it saddens me to think that a lot of you don't really believe that, but you can. But it's all about balance. And it starts with first knowing exactly what you want. You have to know what you want. You have to know what you really desire. Express that to the person. You never know. You never know what a person can bring you and what they can give you. You never know what they may surprise you with. So be open, you know? And I'm not saying just totally give all your trust away, but we have to learn to give people the benefit of the doubt. You never know what to truly expect. Right? So we have to be willing to give people a chance to be themselves. And it starts with you. It starts with you being real, being honest, letting them know where your mind is, where your heart is. Listen, right now I'm focused on my kids. My kids is going off to college soon. I need to make sure I have their college money in place. You tell this person that. You know, don't start dating this person and have them, you know, fall in love with you and then start stressing and cursing them out and now you don't want nothing to do with them. That's not right. That is not fair at all. You need to let them know what your plans are. If you decide that you want to go to school in another 2 years, you need to let them know that. Listen, I love you. I fucks with you. You know, you sweet and everything. But right now, in about another year or so, I would like to go back to school. Okay? But you cannot not tell your plans, fall in love with this person, or have this person fall in love with you, and then expect them to just be okay with your rapid changes or your rapid plans. Like, it does not work that way. I mean, you can do it, and you can tell them your ideas and things that you want to do, but I recommend that you do all these things in the beginning. Now, I also understand a lot of people find themselves when they date people, so you may not have any huge, crazy plans when you meet people, but you should. Everyone should have at least a five-year goal when they're dating or when they're looking for love. Everybody should have a five-year goal. And that person that you of interest deserve to know what that five-year goal is, okay? You have to have a goal in mind. You have to, because that shows that you care about yourself. And that makes the person desire you even more. But, oh, okay, they got themselves together. They might not have all the money in the world or have the biggest car in the world, but they got a plan, right? And even though plans fail, I'm in their life now, right? Like, you can say that. Okay, well, if I be with him or if I be with her, right, then I know that my business will grow. I know that she got a business mindset, or I know that he has a business mindset. I know that he knows a lot about cars, or I know that he knows a lot about music. Whatever it is, right? You have to have a five-year plan. You have to know what each other is about. So that way, when you get together, it's like, okay, oh, I remember, babe, you told me you wanted to go back to school. Yeah, that's great. Oh, you did enroll? That's excellent, baby, right? Like, you can be fully supported because you're not shocked or surprised. Like, they're not like, hey, I got a baby on the way, or hey, I'm about to just leave my career with my pensions and everything to go do landscape or to go be a singer or to go, they don't have no drastic plans popping out the blue, right? It would feel so much better if everyone were just as honest as possible as they could be, okay? So guys, I have to go. I didn't want to talk too long. I went over my 20-minute mark anyway, but I love you and stay tuned, okay? Every Saturday, guys, I'm going to be going live at noon, okay, to talk to you about many, many, many different topics. So tune in. Don't forget, I did set my reminder so that I can be on time, but we're going to test this thing out together because we got to get better at this. And shout out to all of you that have been sending me messages and emails saying that you miss me, you love me. You guys are the best, okay? Thank you for subscribing, okay? And also subscribe to my live chat, guys. Make sure that you guys tune in and subscribe and send those emails so that way you guys can get all of the updates and all of the best news that's coming, okay? But I do have something exciting for you guys soon, okay? So I love you. Bye. Oh.